Prahlad Maharaj is considering himself to be unfit for worshipping the Lord. He says, Kintu stummarahati same hari rugra jate. Ugra jate, as I was speaking yesterday, that Chili caste, those were very much in fallen condition by quality. This quality, it is not that one is fallen in quality, he cannot be raised. It is not like that. The practical example is that our European, American students, actually they were fallen in quality. They were in the modes of ignorance and passion, the fallen quality. But they have been raised. So even one is in fallen condition or in fallen quantity, he can be raised, just like Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj is considering himself that I am fallen. I am born of a father who is fallen, ugrajat. But he is actually not fallen because he is a devotee. He is not fallen. Just like Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur was born in Mohammedan family. But these so-called Brahmins, they thought that he is fallen. But actually he was not fallen. Why? But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted him as the greatest of all chanter, Namacharya. He was the acharya of spreading renown, ideal, symbol, chanting Hare Krishna mantra 3 lakh times, 300,000 times. Practically whole day and night, 24 hours, he was chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. So he was not fallen. But he considered himself as fallen. He was not entering the Jagannath temple. He was living outside. Why he? Even Sanatana Goswami, because he mixed with the Mohammedan emperors. His friends, his master, were the big, big Mohammedan kings and nawabs. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu reclaimed him. The Brahmin society rejected him, outcasted him. That you have accepted, also changed his name, Davir Khas. His Hindu name was changed. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu claimed, and they became Goswami. Bande Rupa Sanatana Raghujigo, Sri Jiva Gopal. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement. All Vaishnava movement is like that. There is no consideration of fallen or high. No. Anyone, Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta Sai Guru, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, anyone who knows the science of Krishna consciousness, he is Guru. It doesn't matter by birth what he is. He may be a Brahmin, he may be a Shudra, he may be a householder, Grihastha, or he may be a Sannyasi. Because Krishna consciousness is transcendental to this bodily concept of life. This Varnasam Dharma, 4 Varnas, Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra, and 4 Ashramas, namely, Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyasa. they are meant for this bodily concept of life. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore said that I am neither a Brahmin, nor a Kshatriya, nor a Vaishya, nor a Shudra. Neither I am Brahmachari, nor Grihastha, nor Vanaprastha, nor Sannyasi. He kept himself, Naham Vipra Nachanarapati, kept himself aloof from these Varnasam Dharma. Of course, this Varnasam Dharma is the beginning of human civilization. Unless one comes to this state or institution accepting this Varnasam Dharma, he is not to be considered as human being or civilized human being. Varnasam Acharvata Purushena Parapuma Vishnu Aradhate Punsha Nana Tattvusukara. Because the whole aim of life is to go back to home, back to Godhead, Vishnu. We have forgotten Vishnu, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, we are loitering in this material world under different species of life in different planetary systems. Brahmanda Bhramite, we are wandering. Why? Because we have forgotten Vishnu. Therefore, this human form of life is meant for realizing Vishnu. But we do not know. Nate vidu sartha gatim hi Vishnu. Om tad Vishnu paramam padam sadapasanti suraya. This is Vedic, Rig Ved mantra. That those are suraya, advanced, civilized Aryans. They are looking forward to the lotus feet of Lord Vishnu. That is the ultimate goal of life. But unfortunately, the rascal civilization, they are not teaching. They are not giving the opportunity to the human society to realize the highest goal of life. Such a rascal civilization at the present moment. Misleading. It is very regrettable that a man is born, especially in India. Every Indian born after many pious activities. To take birth in India is also is result of past activities. It is so holy land. This holy land. But unfortunately our rascal leaders, they are misleading people. They are trying to make people forget Vishnu, forget Krishna, forget God, and try to imitate the Western industrialization, economic development. But these rascals do not see that in spite of all economic development and industrialization, they are not happy. They do not see, they do not take practical knowledge from the practical life. But it is very unfortunate. Nate vidu sartha gatim hi Vishnu. Generally, they are misled. But at least in India, they should not be misled. Because in India, the Vedas are there. The Vedic literatures are there. This Bhagavat is there. I am reading this Bhagavat. Where it is made? It is made in India. But these rascals, they have forgotten. So much regrettable position of India. They do not care for of this Vedic literature. Their birthright. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives this hint. Bharat humite manushya janma hilo ja. Janma sarthak kari karo paropokar. It is the duty of the Indians to learn all this Vedic literature. Make his life successful in Krishna consciousness and preach the gospel throughout the whole world. That is India's beauty. But these rascals are imitated, which is already finished, fallen. So-called economic development and industrialization. Nati vidu sarthakatingi Vishnu. In Berkeley University, one rascal student was asking Indian student, Swamiji, what this Hare Krishna movement will do? We have to learn now technology. And yes, you learn technology and remain beggar forever. You go and beg, give me rice, give me rice. Now America is stopping this aid. Now the whole government is perplexed. So, this is the position. Apan dhan bilaye diye bhikkha mage porer kache. They have forgotten their own assets and their begging. Give me rice, give me wheat, give me powder mill, give me money, give me loan, give me. And their own assets, they have forgotten. Apan dhan bilaye diye bhikkha mage porer kache. This is position. Because they have been, now one boy, he has come to us, and his father and mother is very much perplexed. Now the boy is mixing with this Krishna Hare Krishna movement. Better let him become Naxalite. They will tolerate their children to become Naxalite, but they will not tolerate that he is going to the American sadhus and becoming Krishna conscious. This is the position. So, because nate vidu sarthakatim hi Vishnu durasayadi bahirattamanina, they do not know the ultimate goal of life is to realize God, Vishnu. Durasa, they are hopelessly hoping against hope. How? Bahirattamanina. This materialistic way of life, they are thinking this is the perfection of it. That is not. That is ugrajata. Ugrajata means those who are born in the modes of material nature, ignorance and passion, they think that this material economic development, exploiting the natural resources, will make them happy. Nate vidu sarthakatim hi Vishnu durasayaje bahirattamani. Why they have become so andha jatha andha irupaniyamana stepi satantra urudami badhya? Because they are being led by blind leaders, andha. They are themselves blind. Everyone is blind. Born blind, otherwise why you are sent to school and colleges to take knowledge? You are born blind. Janmana jayate sudra. Everyone is born like animal. The process of birth by parental sexual intercourse, that is there in the animal life and human life. Therefore, the human life birth is not different from the process of birth of the animals. That Janmanajas, therefore, by birth everyone is a Shudra. Shudra means almost animal. Then Sanskarat Bhavendriya. The second birth is required. Not finished, that birth. Birth by father and mother, that is first birth. That is as usual to the animals and to the man. There is no difference. The process of birth is the same. But the next birth, sanskarad bhavet dija, the reformatory method, garbhadan sanskar. Before giving birth to a child, there is a sanskar, there is a ceremony. That is called garbhadan sanskar. And the higher caste, especially the Brahmin Kshatriyas, unless they observe the Brahmadan Sanskar, immediately he becomes a Shudra. So in this age, Kali Yuga, Kalo Shudra Sambhava, almost everyone is born Shudra. Everyone. Kalo Shudra Sambhava, because there is no Garbhadhan Sanskar. So where is the question of becoming Brahmin, Kshatriya and Vaishya? That is not possible. So these are the process of Varnasam Dharma, but they have left anything. Now simply by force one is claiming that I am Brahmin, I am Kshatriya, I am Vaishya. That is false claim. Ugrajata, actually Ugrajata, unfit for self-realization. But it is the mercy of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It is the mercy of Lord Krishna. Krishna prescribed this method. Maang hi partha vipas sritya jupisu papajuna sriya sudra tatha vaishya stipi janti parangati. So Krishna has given open order for everyone that if anyone takes shelter of his lotus feet, vipas sritya, Jeepishu Papajana, Papajani, they are considered Papajani. Those who are not under the reformatory method, they are called Papajani. Impious species of life. Even women are considered like this. Sriya. Not all women, these fallen women, they are also considered. This is the statement. Shudra, Sri Shudra and Vaishya. They are considered on the same platform. So, but our point is that even we are in the fallen condition of life, there is no impediment to make our progress in Krishna consciousness. There is no impediment. Maang hi partha vipas sritya jipishu pabhajuna sriyavishya tatha sudra. In Srimad Bhagavat also it is said, Kirat Hunam Hulinda Bhukkasa Abhira Sumbha Javanakasa. Generates of Papa, even others, most abominable. They can Suddhanti, they can be purified by accepting this Krishna consciousness. Therefore, this movement is scientifically being propagated on the authority of Vedic literature. Not that we have manufactured some movement. So, everyone, it doesn't matter. Balad Maharaj will explain that. Because all these demigods, Brahma and others, asking me to pacify the Lord, then it is to be understood that manne, I therefore think, dhanavi jana rupa tapasutauja, teja prabhava balapau rasabuddhi yoga, naradhanai bhavanti parasya punsa, bhaktyatutosa bhagavan, gajajuta pai. Aye mithanai. Therefore he says, manne, I think, because I am fallen, I am born of a father who is not in Satagun. He is in Rajagun, Tamagun. So therefore, I am Ugrajata. But still, Brahma and other demigods has ordered me to pacify the Lord and offer prayers. So by calculation, it is not possible that I shall offer my prayers to the Lord. But because they have recommended me, therefore I think, manne. Manne, he says manne. Manne means, therefore I think. What is that? Na dhanavi jana rupa tapasutauja. Dhana, riches. हरितोषणे सस्य अजगता आसंख्य Yogutang sambhavayati manne iti dabhyam. Siddhar Swami said that Paritoshane, actually I'm unfit to offer any prayer. Just like it is a system. A Brahmin is allowed to worship the deity. Not a non-Brahmin. That is the Vedic system. But he was son of a person who is less than a Shudra. He was a Rakshas. Therefore, he was unfit from birth. So therefore, Sridharmāne said that evaṁ haritoṣane sa ajogyatā āsaṅkya. He was doubting about his eligibility to worship the Lord. Actually, unless one is situated on the platform Brahma realization, one is unfit to offer any worship to the Lord. Krishna says that jisam antagatam papam jananam punyakarmanam te dandamohani mukta bhajanti imam dhiravrata. So, lower birth means they are not free from the resultant action of sinful life. That is lower birth. And Krishna says that unless one is free from the contamination of sinful life, one cannot become a devotee. Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj, he knows, because he is a devotee, he knows. Now, Sridhar Swami is commenting, asankhya, doubting his eligibility to worship the Lord. He is doubting. Asankhya, haritoshane sa yogyatā, yogyatām asankhya, yogyatām sambhavayati manne. So, he is thinking twice. He is first of all thinking, because I am born of a father who is so abominable, therefore by birth I am, because this body is my father's body. So the father's quality must be there. But at the same time, he says, the manne, then I think that one can become transcendental to this bodily concept of life simply by engaging himself in Krishna consciousness. Sagunan samatitta itan brahma bhuyaya kalpa. Anyone who engages himself in the Lord's service, in full Krishna consciousness, he becomes transcendental to all material qualities. Material qualities mean satagun, rajagun, tamagun. Sagunan samatitva itan brahma bhuyakal. The same way, what is the sound? Cut, 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 cut. Therefore, he said, manne, I think. So, what is that? Na. Dhana. Dhana means riches. One who has got money. Dhanabhijana. Manne dhana abhijana. Abhijana means aristocracy. Born in very high family, rich family, aristocrat family. Manne dhana abhijana. Abhijana means satkule janma. To take birth in Brahmin family or aristocratic family, a Kshatri family. Brahman, Kshatri and Vaishya, they are not Vaishya, Brahman, Kshatri, they are taken as Satkula, higher aristocratic family, pure family. By culture, not by birth. Satkule janma, rupam, saundarjo, beauty. These things are attractive. Janma isakja sutta sri. The four things. Janma. To take birth in high family, aristocratic family, rich family, that is due to pious activities. Aishadja, to acquire riches, money, immediately after birth, he is proprietor of crores of rupees. This is not accidental. Don't think accidental. To take birth in a rich family, in a high family, that is due to pious activity. Janma isadja sutasya. So these things are being analyzed. Dhana, abhijata, and saundarja, beauty. Beauty also are attractive. If a man or woman is beautiful, he or she becomes attractive. Saundarjam. Srutam. Srutam means panditam. Panditam, education. Sutam, this word is very significant. Panditam does not mean to read only. Panditam means to hear. Srutam. Therefore, Vedas are called Sruti. Sruti. One has to hear from the bona fide spiritual master. Then he can become Pandit. Not that purchasing a book from the market. I purchase one Bhagavad Gita from the market and I read. No, that is not panditta. You must hear. Tad vidhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya upadekshanti tad jnanam jnanina tattva darshan. Tad vidhi, you try to understand. Where? From the tattva darshina. That is called Sruti. He hears. Don't try to become a learned scholar by reading yourself at home. That is not possible. Therefore, Vedas are called Sruti. It has to be heard from a bona fide spiritual master. This very word is here. Sruti. Srutauja. Knowledge received from the bona fide spiritual master by hearing, by giving oral reception. That is knowledge, pandit. That is real pandit. Otherwise, simply ABCD knowledge is not pandit. That is not realization. Therefore, this very word is used. Srutam panditam oja indriya naipannam oja. Power. Power means sense power. Indriyajam. Not important, potent. Indriyajam. Teja. Teja means bodily lust. Kanti. Beautiful. A man or woman is very beautiful. There is a luster from the body. These are material qualities. Teja. Kanti, prabhava, pratapa. Prabhava means if somebody says something, it has to be carried out. Just like a father says to his son, he must do it. A master says to his servant, he must do it. A spiritual master says to his disciple, that is called prabhava, influence. Whatever he says cannot be disobeyed. Prabhava. Then, balang, shariram. Balang means bodily strength. Just like shando. Body, that is also a qualification. Shariram, paurasam, uddama. Enterprise. A man is very enterprising. Especially nowadays, there are many industries. They are enterprising. They invest their money, risk their money, and make further profit out of it. From 20,000 they make 20 lakhs. That is called uddama, enterprise. Then buddhi. Buddhi means prajna, prajna means intelligence. sharp intelligence. That is called buddhi, prajna. Yoga. Then comes yoga is also material. People are very much fond of yoga in the Western country, but they do not know this is only material exercise. Yoga, everyone knows Ashtanga yoga, yam niyam, asana, dhyan dharana, asana, pranayam, dhyan dharana, then pratyahara, then samadhi, ashtanga. Eight kinds of defined process by bodily exercise. That is called yoga. First of all, one has to make yam niyam. It is very difficult. The so-called yogas doing everything and has become a yogi, that is not yogi. First principle of yoga is yam niyam. Sense control. You cannot eat everything. You cannot do everything. That is called yam niyam. Then practice asana. There are different kinds of asana. Then dhyan dharana, pratyaha. There are so many rules and regulations. It is not at all possible for a person in this age. Not only at the present moment, 5,000 years ago, when Arjuna was advised for this yoga practice, Arjuna flatly said, "My dear Krishna, it is not possible." He accepted his inability. Such a personality like Arjuna, who was talking with Krishna face to face, and such a warrior, he felt unable, and now they are practicing yoga, as if they have become more than Arjuna. This is only false, bluff. You cannot practice yoga. And even if you practice yoga, here it is said, you cannot satisfy by yoga practice the Supreme Personality of God. Even if you practice it, first of all, you cannot practice it. It is impossible. At the present age. And even if you practice, Prahlad Maharaj says, even yoga, this yoga, he says, manne dhana bhijana rupa tapasuto uya tija prabhava balapo rasa buddhi yoga. Naradhanaya, these are not qualifications. These material qualifications to become beautiful, to reach, having very bodily strength and a very beautiful luster and practicing yoga, so many things. But they are not, I mean to say, means for offering prayer to the Lord. They are not fit even. Manne, he sees. Because he can see that Brahmadaya Suragana. Suragana means all demigods. They are all qualified with all these material qualities. They are very beautiful. They are very strong. They can practice yoga. Not only, they have attained the perfection of yoga. Ashtasiddhi. Ashtasiddhi animalogima. Prapti. Ishita Bhashita. So many things. There is Siddha Loka. There is a planetary system, Siddha Loka. They are all yogis. They can travel from one planet to another without any aeroplane. Siddha Loka. So, all of them arrived there to pacify Lord Nrisimhadeva. Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj is analyzing manne dhana vijana. Manne dhanabhijana. Rupa tapasutauja tira prabhava balapaurasa buddhi yoga. Because all the demigods, they are all qualified with all these qualities. In high strength, they are qualified. Not like human being. A human being may be very beautiful or very strong or may be successful in yoga practice, but the demigods, they are called demigods because they are thousands and thousands times more perfect than the human. Therefore, they are called demigods, almost God. So, Prahlad Maharaj thinks that these things, ete dhanadaya dadasavapi guna parasra pungsa aradhanaya na bhavanti. All these material qualities, they are not fit qualification for worshipping the Lord. Just see how Krishna is merciful. All these demigods are also unfit to worship Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. Why? Because they are lacking in pure devotional service. They also worship Krishna, because therefore they are called demigods. There are two kinds of men within this universe. One is called Deva and one is called Asura. Asura means they have no connection with God. And Deva means those who have got connection with God. So they have connection with God, the demigods, but for some material profit. Just like Krishna says, artha arthati jigyasu jnani cha vartas chaturvidha bhajante maam. Four classes of men who are distressed, who are in need of money, artha arthati, need of money, jnani and jigyasu. These four classes of men begin their search after God and worship God. That is the beginning. But that is not pure devotion. It is contaminated. That is not pure. These demigods, they have got high post in this material world. Just like we also know, there are many rich families, they have also deities in their house, or they have special Thakurbati, God's house. They do. But their purpose is to take something from Krishna, or Arthati. They are not pure. Although they are devoting very nicely, that is also good qualification, because Krishna said, Chaturvidha bhajante mam jana sukritena Arjuna. Sukriti. Sukriti means they are pious men. Therefore, even though asking something, some benefit by worshipping the Lord, is still they are pious. Therefore, in other words, piety is also not a qualification to approach the Supreme Personality of God. That is also not an apt qualification. It is above. Sagunan samatitvaita, one who can transcend all the qualities. Anna vilasita sunnam. No other desire. I am approaching Krishna, God, to beg something. That is also good. He is going to beg something from Krishna than the rascals who do not come to Krishna. They are better than. They are duskritina. Who are not coming to Krishna. Namang prabhadanti mura duskritina naradhama. They are described as lowest of the mankind. One who does not come to Krishna even for asking something. Because people have become so fallen, they do not go to Krishna to ask. They think, we shall earn, we shall fight, we shall kill, we shall take money from others, then we shall become rich. This is going on. Therefore, the society has so much fallen, because they do not come to Krishna. Duskitena naradhana, lowest of the mankind, and always full of sinful activities. They do not come. But even one comes to Krishna to beg something, some material profit, he is described in the Bhagavad Gita as Sukritina. Sukritina means pious, because he has come to Krishna. That's like Dhruva Maharaj. Dhruva Maharaj went to the forest to worship Krishna, to ask something, material profit, to ask some benefit, his father's property. But the result was that he became a great devotee, so that his name, that was Shastra recommends, that even if you have a desire for some material benefit, still you worship Krishna, not other demons. Akama sarva kama va moksha kama udaradhi tibrena bhakti yogena jajeta paramam purush. Param purush is Krishna. So even you have got kama, you want something materially profitable, still you worship Krishna. The result will be like Dhruva Maharaj. He went to worship Krishna to ask some material benefit, but ultimately he became a great devotee. When he became a devotee, even Kubera, the treasurer of the demigods, he once, Dhruva Maharaj, when he was king, he was fighting with some demons, and by the request of superior Narada, he stopped it. So the demon's forefather, Kubera, was pleased that you have saved my family. So you can take any benefit, you ask me. Kubera means treasurer of the demigod. The whole treasury of the world, he could ask from Kubera Maharaj, Kubera. But Dhruva Maharaj, because he was at that time a pure devotee, he did not ask anything. He said, sir, if you want to give me some benediction, please give me this benediction so that I may have my unflinching faith on the lotus feet of Krishna. This is pure devotee. He could have asked him the whole riches of the whole universe, but no, he did not do it. He simply said that kindly give me this benediction so that my faith on the lotus feet of Krishna may remain forever. You see? So, this is the ultimate goal of life. Nati vidu sartha gatim Vishnu. So, Prahlad Maharaj is pure devotee. He is thinking that although I am low-born, but even those who are high-born, full of riches and beauty and bodily strength and joy, perfection, they are not fit for worshipping the Lord. Manne dhana vijana rupa tapasuta uja tija prabhava balapau rasabuddhi yoga naradhanaya bhavanti parasya punsa. Parasya punsa. Parasya means Krishna or the Lord does not belong to this material world. Therefore Krishna says, abhijananti manga mura manasim tanumasita. The rascals, because I come as human being, they think of me as ordinary human being. But he is para, parasapunsa, narayana para, of bhaktiyat, Shankaracharya said. So, he is parapurusa. Mane, he is above this material world. There is another nature. That is also described in the Bhagavad Gita. Para, tasmad, bhava, anya. Bhava means nature. There is another. Where the Vaikuntha world is. The people do not know. They think these are all fictitious story. So they are so rascal they have become. You see? But these are actual facts. There is another world beyond this material world. We cannot calculate what is the length and breadth of this material world and what we can get information of the spiritual world. But there is. Parastasmat bhavanya bhaktya bhaktya sanatana. That is never destroyed. In this material world, whatever existence is there, they will be destroyed. So even the whole world there, the spiritual world is not destroyed, and the master of the spiritual world, the enjoyer of the spiritual world, Krishna, how he can be like us, like human being? Therefore Krishna says, abhijananti mana mura. Because they have no knowledge, and they think I am ordinary man. Parasya pungsa. So, nobody can worship the parasya pungsa, this transcendental personality, the supreme personality of Godhead, by all these material qualifications, which are acquired even by the demigods. Then, how we can be? Na bhaktya tutosa bhagavan gajajutapa. Bhaktya, by pure devotional service, you can please the Supreme Personality of God. Otherwise, it is not possible. Thank you very much.